Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to write a message into fine, pristine beach sand from scratch, and then how to quickly replace your message without having to redo the effects. This tutorial is an update of one I did on an earlier version of Photoshop. Create a new document by pressing Ctrl-N on Windows or Command-N on a Mac. Name your document and make its width 1550 pixels, its height 870 pixels, and its resolution 72 pixels per inch. The color mode is RGB and 8 bits per channel. Click the small box to open the color picker, and in the hexadecimal field, type in F0E2AF. Then press Enter or Return twice. Open your horizontal type tool. I'm using a font called MV Boley Regular. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link in my video's description or project files. I'll make its size 385 points, but you may want to adjust this amount depending on the font you use and the amount of characters in your text. Make the aliasing smooth and center alignment. For now, the color is irrelevant as long as it's different from the color of the background. Click on your background and type out your text. We want a good amount of breathing room between all the characters, however, in this example, the spacing, also known as tracking or letter spacing, is a bit too wide. To adjust the tracking of your text, highlight all the characters and press Alt or Option plus the right or left arrow key on your keyboard. To adjust the space between just two characters, also known as kerning, click between those characters and repeat the keystrokes. To reposition your text, open your Move tool and just drag it. Next, we'll convert our text into a smart object, so if we want to replace it at some point, it'll automatically and instantaneously reapply all the effects. Click the icon at the upper right of the Layers panel and click Convert to Smart Object. Let's name it Outer. This layer will become the outer portion of your sand text. Go to Filter, Blur, and Gaussian Blur. Blur it 1 pixel and click OK. Reduce the fill to 0%. This makes the image inside the layer invisible, but any effects that we add to it will retain their visibility. Click the FX icon and click Bevel Emboss. Make the style Pillow Emboss, the technique Chisel Hard, the depth 100%, and the direction Down. I'll make the size 50 pixels, however, if you have a lot more characters in your line of text, you may want to decrease this amount. Soften it 5 pixels and uncheck Global Light. Make the angle 120 degrees and the altitude 30 degrees. The highlight mode is Linear Dodge and its opacity is 12%. The shadow mode is Linear Burn, and its opacity is 39%. Then click OK. Make a copy of the text layer by pressing Ctrl or Command J, and name the copy Inner. This will be the inner portion of your sand text. Increase its fill to 100% and double-click Effects to open its layer style window. Click Color Overlay and the color box. Type in your background color and press Enter or Return. Click Bevel and Emboss. Make the style inner bevel. The technique smooth. And the depth 235%. Make the size 27 pixels and soften it 7 pixels. Global light is unchecked. Make the angle 130 degrees and the altitude 48 degrees. Make the highlight opacity 0% and the shadow opacity 30%. Then click OK. To finish your image, we'll add sand texture. Scroll down to the bottom of your layers panel and shift-click on the thumbnail of the background to make all the layers active. Convert them into one smart object. Go to Filter, Noise, and Add Noise. Make the amount 3%, Gaussian, and monochromatic. To replace your text, double-click the thumbnail of your sand text to open its source layers. Then, double-click on any smart object to open your original text. If you want to replace it with a much longer line, go to Image and Canvas Size. Change the parameters to percent and increase the width. I'll type in 140% to ensure I have enough space and click OK. To see the entire file on your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. To replace your text, first, double-click the large T of your text layer to highlight your line of text, and drag your text size to the left to decrease its size. Then, type out your new text and adjust its spacing. To accept it, click the check mark at the top. Close the tab of your text, and when you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. Then, to add the sand texture, close the tab of your other smart object, and again, click Yes to save the changes. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.